YouTube, so today I am doing my first impressions video. It is on the Tarte Amazonian Clay 12-hour full coverage foundation. Apparently it is 12-hour makeup and it is oil free. I'm in shade light medium honey, and I think I picked a pretty good shade. I bought this off QVC, the website, and it's basically £36 for the foundation, and you get a free Tarte brush with it, which I absolutely love. So worth it just for the brush alone. So that's where I ordered mine off, and I thought I tried to do a few look up a few reviews before I tried out. I bought this foundation, and there was a few, but there wasn't as many as what I thought. So I thought it would be fun if I done one for you too. So basically my thoughts so far are I'm loving it. You'll see when I I'm going to pop in a clip of me applying it as well. And yeah, so there's a clip of me applying it, and then I will continue telling you what I think about it throughout the day, and then my final thoughts at night. So if you want to see what I think of my first impressions of the Tarte Amazonian Clay Foundation, then please keep watching. Okay, so this is the packaging. Excuse my face, I have broke out a wee bit. Lately, I think I used a foundation that didn't agree with me, and I'm not sure which one because I've been trying out a few. So I'm going to have to figure out what one doesn't agree with my skin and get rid of it. So this is the packaging. I think the packaging's gorgeous. It's in a squeezy tube, so you literally get the most out of your money, because you can completely squeeze everything out of it. You get 50 milliliters in it, which is a lot, because if I get my MAC one you only get 30, so I think it's really good that you get more than MAC. Okay, so I'm just going to get into kind of showing you how I'm going to put it on, and hopefully the colour's good. Of course I'm applying it with the Tarte just kind of like brush. I don't know what the brush is called. I'll link it down below. I think the best way to maybe apply it is like squeeze it out of the tube. Okay, it's very, very thick consistency. Hopefully the colour's gonna be okay. It kind of feels a wee bit moussey. And it is definitely yellow undertone. So if I keep looking over that side, because I have a mirror there. I got the colour light medium honey. Which so far the colour is looking okay, because it is very yellow undertone and I like that. Okay, so I've kind of got a wee bit on. I'm going to try and work with it from here and see what kind of coverage I can get out of this. So let's see if I can. I'm just going to buff it in. So far I am loving this brush. It just feels so nice on the skin, and it feels like it's buffing it in really nicely. Although for a full coverage foundation, because it does say full coverage foundation, I don't think it's completely full, but maybe I need to just add a wee bit on, a wee bit more. So plus my skin hasn't been great because of a foundation that I have used. I think I have an idea what one, but I think I need to try it out again and see if I break out more, and then I can definitely realise what one it is and get rid of it. Okay, so that's my skin after one light layer. Okay, can still see a spot there, can still see a spot there. I'm going to add more and see what kind of build up it can get, and if you can layer it without it looking cakey. So I'm going to just do a wee bit more on my cheeks and a wee bit more on my head, my chin. I have to say, it feels like I am wearing nothing on my face. It is so lightweight. I'm going to try to like stipple it on a wee bit to get the most coverage. Sorry if you can hear like jingling. It's my Michael Kors bracelet and it's got the wee lock on it, so it always jiggles, so I'm taking it off. Okay. I'm not putting it right up under my eyes because I like to wear concealer, because I just have a concealer that doesn't crease. Okay. So a wee bit better on the cheeks. That's the kind of second layer, and I have to say I think I like it. First impressions, I've got a wee bit, it kind of looks a wee bit shiny here, but I'm going to powder it because I powder every single foundation I wear, no matter how matte it claims to be. I powder every foundation, although this doesn't say it's supposed to be matte, it just says it's the Amazonian Clay 12-hour Full Coverage Foundation. So it doesn't say it's supposed to be matte, which I kind of thought it did, but when I got it, it obviously doesn't. I'm going to blend it down my neck. I think I got like the perfect colour. And yeah, so let's try this. Okay, I'm going to go and do my concealer, blusher. I'm not putting concealer on my face, just under my eyes, so I'm not putting it on any spots or anything, because I think it's actually covered my spots really, really well for like the second kind of coating. I'm gonna finish off my my bottom mascara and bottom eyeshadow, and then I'll be back. So okay, so I've done my bottom mascara and eyeshadow, my powder, which is the Rimmel Stay Matte powder, which I absolutely love, my blush, my bronzer, my lipstick, and so far I am loving this foundation. It feels like I have nothing on my face. It is the lightest full coverage foundation I have ever used in my entire life so far, and I think it just looks really like flawless and natural on the skin. It doesn't look cakey, and so far I am extremely impressed. So a thumbs up from me so far. Okay, it is currently 1 o'clock and I am starting work soon, so I have to go to work, and then I'll be back with a wee update of how I think the foundation is holding up. Okay, so it is now I don't know if you can see, 6:24, and I have been to work, I've came home, I have lounged about, been touching my face, yeah, pretty much been just doing everything today, and I love this foundation. I think it's still really held up. I have not touched it once with powder, and I have oily skin, and I don't really think, maybe a wee tiny bit of oil here, but even then it's not really that shiny. I am so impressed. Like, this foundation has done wonders, and it doesn't even say that it's like supposed to be for oily skin or anything. So far I'm impressed. It has lasted over six and a half hours so far, and boy, I am so happy, because see, normally by about 4 or 5 hours I have to powder just because I get so oily. So I am giving it the thumbs up for now, and I'm going to actually keep it on a wee bit longer because it does say it's supposed to last 12 hours. So I might come back maybe just before I'm about to take my makeup off or whatever and give you my final thought. But so far I am absolutely loving it. So I just thought I'd check in with you and do a quick update, saying I've been to work and I've really tried out this foundation today. I've just been feeling the brush again. I love this brush so much. I think seeing you get it for free with the foundation on QVC, like, holy crap guys, like, if you're not even gonna get it for foundation, get it for the brush, because it's so good. But yeah, foundation I think looks really nice, and actually when I was in work a lady said to me that she really liked my foundation and asked what it was, so that's always a plus side. So yeah, I'll call back in with you later to tell you what else I think of the foundation. Okay, so it is now, let me check, my phone. It is now 9:30 at night. And basically I am about to take my makeup off to get a shower. I have had this on from 1 o'clock today, so it's been on for 9 hours. And I have been completely impressed up until about the last hour, where I feel it's kind of started to separate on my nose. But I think that's because I haven't powdered once today. So I think if I had it powdered, it would have stayed on better. So overall, I give this foundation about 8 out of 10, just for the fact that it did separate with oil. But at the end of the day, I would never leave it this long to not powder anyway. So yeah, that's kind of what I think of the foundation. I would love to know if you have tried this foundation. Please comment down below. Yeah, and I filmed my makeup collection tonight, which should be up before this. So if you haven't seen it and you're watching this, go check it out. So yeah, thanks for watching, guys. And I really hope you like my first impression video. And if you want me to do any other ones on any other project, please comment down below. So yeah, thanks so much for watching, guys, and I'll see you in the next video. Bye.